chapter 6. I'm reading from verse 1. Media, I'm waiting for you. And just in case you are writing, don't forget, you are here to learn. Tonight, we are studying God's word. John chapter 6, I read from verse 1. After these things, Jesus went over to the Sea of Galilee, which is the Sea of Tiberias. I want you to flow. Just in case you are writing, what an ideal church is. So I'll be teaching on the ideal church. Come on, what did I say? The ideal church. Now, if there is an ideal church, it means we can have a church that is not ideal. Look at the first set of people you will meet in the church that is not ideal. Verse 2. I want you to write down. Point number 1. The first category of people you meet in a church that is not the ideal church. And a great multitude, that is what the Bible says, followed him because they saw his miracles which he did on them that were diseased. This is not an ideal church. The Bible said the great multitude came. Now, why they came? They didn't come because the Bible says they came because, verse 2, I want you to put it in that. Because of the miracle was why they came. They were not there because of Jesus. They were there because of the miracle. Praise the name of the Lord. They saw the signs. They saw the wonders. They saw the miracles. So they didn't come because of who Jesus is. They didn't come because they want to learn of Jesus. But the motivation was the miracle. So I didn't say so. The Bible said so. If you read it, the Bible says, Brother Ernest, he said they came because. So every other reason wouldn't have brought them to church. Outside of miracle, they will come to church. Oh, are you against pastor? I need to teach us, because we need to know what an ideal church is. An ideal church should be miracle producing church, not miracle following church. Is God against miracle? No. Does God want us to experience miracle? Yes. But the Bible says these people, a great multitude, everybody say multitude, they didn't come to hear the word. They didn't come to say, Jesus, you are Lord. Hear what the Bible says. Because they saw. And as long as they saw the miracles, we are going to church because of miracles. Now, it means that the day they stop seeing miracles, they have left the church. Oh, come on. As we progress, you will see it. Now, these are believers who want to be in a church that is the best in everything. Is that our church? It's an ego trip. It's a church that every day is our church, but you have not known the Jesus of the church. Hello. The Bible says that they came because they saw the miracles. They saw sickness. And do you know, this is the generation we find ourselves. If a pastor is casting out devils, others become spectators. No. He does not want you to be a spectator. He wants you to participate in everything that happens. This is not an ideal church. I didn't say it. The Bible says that they followed Jesus because of the miracle they saw. So if there was no miracle, they wouldn't follow Jesus. Help me tap your neighbor. That is not an ideal church. Say to your neighbor, an ideal church transcends signs and wonders, miracles. Praise the name of the Lord. Can I give you point number 2? Verse 15. Look at the next category of people that came to Jesus. Verse 15. When Jesus therefore perceived that they would come and take him by force to make him king, he departed again into a mountain himself. This same multitude, as they followed Jesus, the next step, my brother, hey, we're going to make him king. He should be our king. Now, before you understand that statement, king, you should understand what they were under. They were under the Roman Empire. They were under the Roman rulership. They wanted freedom from the Roman authority. And what they needed another leadership that would deliver them from the hands of the polities of their day. So, there are people who go to church. The one I will refer to, the church that is not an ideal church, they will go to that church because there is political connection there. We are going there because we need leadership. We are going there because we need someone to speak on our behalf so that we can have an appointment. These people needed strong leadership. They wanted someone that would deliver them from the hands of the Roman authority. But if you check, for their personal gain. Everybody said they did it for their personal gain. Help me say to your neighbor, that is not an ideal church. So it means that if there's no governmental connection, they have forgotten the Jesus of the church. Please, I'm teaching you the Bible. I need to share with you. You know, one of the characteristics of the end time, he said, in the end time, false prophets shall arise and false teachers. The Bible said they will show great signs and wonders that if care is not taken, the even elect, they will be deceived. So, God is not against signs and wonders, but that is not why you are serving him. Tap your neighbor. Say, he's done so much for me. The proof of his love is that he died for me. Every other thing will attend to me. True of us. It's better we settle it. It's better we settle it. Then this category of people are people who feel I must contact for that connection. Let somebody know about me. That is the essence. But church is not about the position we get. Can I shock you? The day you die, you go with no position to heaven. You only need those things on earth. Pastor, are you teaching so that we don't aspire? That should not be the main objective of coming to church. You can be in church and God can lift you. But the purpose why you come to church is not to look for governmental connection. Can I hear an amen from somebody? Yeah. Tap your neighbor, say, it is you pastor is talking to. Now, did you notice that Jesus was not drawn to the politics of his day? So they will be disappointed because Jesus was not even involved in politics. And that is the truth of the matter. When a church that is not an ideal church clamors over political position, it means they have missed their place in God. Can I hear an amen from somebody? Can I tell you the next category that is not an ideal church? Verse 26. I'll be teaching from just this chapter. Is it okay by you? I just want to share it with you. Because if you read on, is this great multitude from verse 2 that are the people that we are examining tonight. Jesus answered them and said, verily, verily, I say unto you, you seek me, not because you saw the miracle, but because you did eat of the loaves and were filled. So, the next category that is not the ID church are people who go to church because of food. I didn't say it. The Bible says, you seek me not because you saw miracles. So, it means this is not the category of the miracle. But you seek me because you saw the loaves multiply. And you know what that does? Let me follow this man. I am sure my food is guaranteed. ideal church is. This is not the ideal church. This is not the ideal church. A church or a group of people who seek Jesus only because of food. Can I shock you? Jesus died for something much more than miracles. He died for something much more than political position. He died for something much more than food. If Jesus needed to die for these three things I mentioned, he didn't need to die. Can I hear an amen from somebody? It's not the ideal church. Because the question that is coming to your mind, Pastor, what then is the ideal church? Jesus does not just want to provide for you. Follow him because of food. Tap your neighbor. Say, not because of food. For his hello, are we sit together? The next 30, come verse 30. Let's read loud. What sign showest thou then that we may see and believe thee? What dost thou work? This category of people that is not the ideal church, they always want to test Jesus. Show us a sign that you are actually from God. They were looking for a sign to trap Jesus. I will give you another scripture to it so you understand what I'm saying. That people, they come to church. And you know, Silas, you told me that our church is too much. Now I'm coming to the church. Let God give me a sign that truly this is his house. They are looking for a reason to prove that this church is the church of the Lord. And they did it because they wanted to trap Jesus. Praise the name of the Lord. Now, I want to add another scripture to it that you will like. John 3 verse 37. John 3 37. John chapter 3 verse 37. 37 of John chapter 3. These are people who are looking for opportunity to trap Jesus. You said you are Jesus. Nah, that is not the ideal church. You don't come to church to trap Jesus. Jesus, okay, if truly that you are Lord in my life, show me that my husband. John 3, 37. Show me that my husband. We don't do all those things because 11, 37. Let me read. John 11, 37. Can I read? And some of them said, could not this man which opened the eyes of the blind have caused that even this man should not have died? When they heard about the death of Lazarus, the first thing they said, this man who is so close to this family, couldn't this man have been able to prevent the death of this man? But yet they don't know Jesus. The Bible says messengers had come to Jesus 3-4 days earlier on. And the Bible said, Jesus told his disciples, our friend Lazarus is sleeping. Let's go and wake him up. And hear what the disciples said. If he's sleeping, he will wake up. But he was speaking about his death. But at the end of the day, all they were doing, they wanted to trap him. I want to prophesy tonight. Every question men have been asking shall be answered. That amen lacks vitamin D. I don't know what men have been trying to laugh at you with. To say, if okay, you go to church, this. There are people there just in church. That is not the ideal church. Looking for questions. Let's trap Jesus. Let's see how God will do it. Let's see how God will work that miracle in your life. That is not the ideal church. Praise the name of the Lord. I'd like to read another verse. How many points have we mentioned? Are you sure? We have read only 4 points? I'm not sure. Okay, let's check
verse 34. Let's see verse 34. Of John, no, John 6. That is our emphasis. Verse 34. John 6, verse 34. Hallelujah. John chapter 6. If you are there, say amen. See 34. Then said they unto him, Lord, evermore, give us. You know what they were saying? We acknowledge that you are the one that provides food. We don't want to see you as a source, but we just want to see you as the one giving. There are people, they just want to come to church. That is not the ideal church. He said, as you get to that church, you will see your door will open, things will open. And if they stay the first month, second month, 1 year, things open, things close, things open, things close. They want to serve God for things, but they don't want to acknowledge the lordship of Jesus Christ. Tap your neighbor, say, don't serve him for things. Acknowledge his lordship over your life. Oh, they are looking for, you know, fulfillment. Just give us this bread forevermore. They are looking for fulfillment, but they don't want to acknowledge the source. I never forget what somebody once said. He said, men are your resources. God is your source. They saw Jesus, not as their source, but they just saw him as the one that can give us bread. Ladies and gentlemen, he gives much more than bread. He's the Lord over your life. That's why we sing, he is Lord. He is Lord. He is Lord over everything that you will ever need. And the ideal church must celebrate the lordship of Jesus. I will come to your church after 3 months. If I don't get what I'm looking for, I will go back. Wrong. If you go back, you don't go back, Jesus is still Lord. You don't serve him because you need to get things. But if you follow him, things will follow you. I don't know if people are understanding what I'm saying. The first point is that multitude followed because they saw what? What was the second point? The second point was the fact that they were looking for strong leadership, isn't it? Political leadership. And the fact Jesus will provide such political leadership. Is that okay by us? What was the other point we established? They came because of, let's eat. Okay, if we say every Thursday we have buffet in this place, I'm sure that if service begins by 6, by 4:30, this place would have been crowded. Some will even put bags on empty chairs, securing seats for those who have not come. Pastor, are you saying that Jesus does not provide this thing, but that should not be the reason we follow him? Are you hearing what I'm just saying? What point have we mentioned? How many points have we mentioned? 4 or 5? Won't you leave 4? You have been point 4 since. We are going to the 5th point now. Are we? 6th. 6th point now. Verse 68. Should we read verse 68 or we start from verse 65 to give you an idea? Let's read from verse 65. Don't forget we're still dealing with the multitude. Are we dealing with the multitude? Verse 65. And he said, therefore said I unto you that no man can come unto me except it were given unto me of my Father. So they came, but not all of them were given by the Father. True? Let's continue. Let's enjoy ourselves and Bible study. From that time, many of his disciples, and walked no more with him. No, nobody's in church today. Jesus just told them, all this multitude, you have been following me because of your own personal reasons. No man can come to me except the Spirit of my Father draw such a person. The Bible says, from that time, we are no longer coming to your church again. Jesus, we have stopped your church. Just because Jesus told them the truth. He said, you seek me
because of bread. You seek me because of miracle. You seek me because of strong leadership. You seek me because you want to trap me. You are telling me, if I don't do this, if I don't do this. You seek me for your own personal reasons. Jesus now said, no man can come to me except the spirit of my Father draws that person. And the Bible says, from that time, many of his disciples went back. We will follow you again. Why? We were following you because of what we could get. We are not getting it. That is not the idea, church. Come on. Look at what the Bible says. And walk no more with him. Next verse. Let's enjoy ourselves. Next verse. Doctor comes, are you blessed? Then said Jesus unto the 12, will you also go away? Everybody look up. Now, how do you explain it? You are the pastor of a church, or you are the pastor of a church. You are the pastor of a church that multitude followed you. And then you already discerned to know why they followed you. You started explaining to them, these are the reasons, and all of a sudden they left you. Out of the multitude, don't forget it began with multitude. Only 12 remain. If it is our present generation, we say that pastor had sin in his life. A crowd can be in a place that does not show that God is in that place. Jesus, I'm teaching Jesus. I'm not teaching any other thing. I'm telling you about the ID church. Hello. Come on. Multitude. Do you know what it is? Pastor Ehis is coming to Vinefield Church. And then the whole road is blocked. He said, wow, what a servant of God he is. The man of the moment. The man of the hour. What are these people following me for? Are they coming because of what we are about to examine? Or they are coming for their personal reasons? Am I still talking to somebody? Can we look up? How many persons left? All. No, I didn't say how many left. How many? All. How many left? How many left? No, how many? The number that is left with Jesus now. Now, verse 2 began with how many? Multitude. No, come on. Think about it. So the multitude have their various reasons of coming to church, which is not the ideal church. Can I move on? Let's move on. Then Simon Peter answered him, Lord, to whom shall we go? So when Jesus said, why are you people still with me? Come and join them. I don't care if everybody leaves. You know what Simon Peter said? He said, Lord, to whom shall we go? That's the first question. You know, people mistake that word to be Peter understood everything. No, Peter still did not understand. Peter simply was asking, to whom shall we go? I was a fisherman. All of a sudden, you called me. What Peter meant with that statement is, where am I going to start from? So people will say, I have followed Jesus. I'm now a local person in the business that I used to do. Where am I going to start from? That was what Peter was saying. To whom shall we go? Where am I going to start from? I used to be a fisherman. I left my occupation. Now, you are telling me, should I not go? And I'm asking you, where will I go? No space again. They have occupied everywhere. Where am I going to? Peter was, I abandoned all. I followed Jesus. I'm unsure of my personal life now. Some of us will even say, I've been a pastor since. I didn't know this Jesus would deceive me. Can I say something? When Jesus called you as a pastor, he didn't call you because of a car. When he called you, he didn't call you because of a house. He called you because he has an assignment for you to the people. Every other thing that comes, they are side attraction. Did you hear what I said? They are not the reasons he called you. If they were the reasons he called you, when you die, you carry everything. Who is in church today? Tap your neighbor, say, I'm sure. I'm a part of the ID church. So with the spirit of fear and anxiety, Peter would have made this statement. Let me prove that to you. Matthew chapter 10. Let's read verse 26 to 28. Peter was not so sure of his future. He needed to be reassured. Whoever is on the console, Matthew 10, Mark 10, sorry. 26 to 28. Mark 10, 26 to 28. He wanted to be sure. Mark 10, 26 to 28. Can I read? And they were astonished. Okay, they are there. Out of measure, saying among themselves, who then can be saved? Next verse. And Jesus, looking upon them, said, with men it is impossible, but not with God. For with God all things are possible. Verse 28. Then Peter began to say unto him, lo, we have left all and have followed you. That was what he meant by saying, to whom shall we go? We have left all. Where will we start from now? If it is fishing business, they have new techniques that we don't know. Technology has taken over everything. To whom? So there are people who come to church, which we refer to not the ID church. They come because they are not sure of their future. So, but let me just follow Jesus. Point number six, those who are unsure of their future, let's just follow. Then my teaching tonight will start from the next verse in chapter 6 of John, verse 69, will be where our teaching will start from tonight. So that you know the mind of God for the ID church. Can I hear an amen from somebody? Who is blessed already tonight? I'm happy. Whether Jesus gives me husband or not, Jesus is still Lord. True of us? Whether Jesus gives me a car or not, is he still Lord? Whether Jesus gives me a house or not, is he still what? Lord, between now and tomorrow, if you don't give me a car, I will backslide. Whether you backslide or not, Jesus is still Lord. Things don't make him. He made everything. I don't know who is hearing what we're saying. Help me look at your neighbor and say, things don't make him. He made everything. Now, when we don't understand who he is, we want to use things to get his attention. They saw the miracle. Because of the miracle, they followed. They saw someone who had respect before the Roman people. They felt, look, we have strong leadership in this man. They saw a man who could feed them. They said, this is someone we can follow for food. And all the points we have mentioned. But Jesus said, it is much more than this. You must see me as a source. That is the ideal church. The ideal church sees the source of the church. And Jesus is the source of the church. I don't know if I'm talking to somebody yet. So Peter was asking, to whom shall we go? Let's get back to our text. What's our text? John 6, from verse 6. Now we are reading verse 69, if you please. John 6. Verse 68. Let's finish verse 68. And this is what God wants. Are we there? Look at what the Bible says. Then Simon Peter answered him, Lord, to whom shall we go? Thou hast the word of what? Eternal life. This is the ID church. Verse 69. And we believe and are sure that thou art that Christ, the Son of the living God. Peter and the rest of the disciples would have left him. What kept them was that they believed he was their source. The ID church is a church that believes that Jesus is their source. He said, and we believe and are sure. We are no longer uncertain. We are no longer afraid of our future. Let everybody go, we will not go. We know who you are. You are that Christ. You are that anointed one. You are that Messiah. You are the Son of the living God. Hebrews chapter 1 verse 3, the Bible says he upholds all things by the word of his power. Jesus is the source of your life. He's the source of the miracle. He's the source of that strong political leadership you are looking for. He's the answer to your question. Jesus is everything about your future. I want you to understand something. The Bible says in Jeremiah 29 verse 11, he said, I know the thought that I think towards you. They are thoughts of good and not of evil, to give you an expected end. You don't need to be unsure about your future. Your future is secure in Jesus. The Bible said multitude followed him, but they didn't understand he was their source. That is not the ideal church. The ideal church is a church that have come to know and believe that Jesus is the Messiah. He's the Son of the living God. We are not following him because we want to get things. We know that he is our Messiah. He is the anointed one. He is the Son of the living God. He is the one that upholds all things. And if he upholds all things, he gives all things. Everybody say, the multitude left him. Can you say, the multitude left him? Can you tell me why they left him? They didn't know that what they were looking for, he was the source of those things. What they wanted, he was the source of all things. The ideal church is a church that have come to a conclusion. Whether I live or die, Jesus is Lord. Whether I get that contract or not, Jesus is Lord. Whether I am married or I'm not married, Jesus is Lord. Because I know if he's Lord, I must marry. If it's Lord, I will get that contract. If it's Lord, I will have children. If it's Lord, I will have a wife. If it's Lord, I will have a husband. Whatever it is, once I acknowledge him, he's my source. He's my source. That is the ideal church. But not a church that we run into because we need things. But a church that will look for the source. He is a giver. Stop looking for the gift. Look for the giver. I don't know if I'm communicating. People pursue after the gift, but they have forgotten the giver. People run after healing, but they have forgotten the healer. People run for political appointment, looking for Godfather, but they forget he is the father of all fathers. People are looking for kingmakers, but he is the King of Kings. Am I speaking to somebody here? My motivation must be that he is the source. Peter said, where are we going to? Our future is uncertain. But then we realize something. You are the Christ, the Son of the living God. You remember an account similar to this? In Matthew chapter 16, when Jesus got into Caesarea of Philippi, he asked, who do men say that I am? And some said, you are Elias. Some said, you are John the Baptist. He turned to his disciple, who do you say that I am? And in that state of confusion, Peter spoke up, thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. You know what he said? Flesh and blood. It's because flesh and blood will only tell you about things. Only the spirit will show you the source. Look at your neighbor. Say, flesh and blood will tell you about things. Only the spirit will reveal the Son. You remember that account? He said, flesh and blood. Please, I want you to listen to this. Flesh and blood has not revealed this. He said, but the spirit of my Father has shown you this thing. You know the next statement? He said, nevertheless, upon this rock, was he talking about Peter? Peter is not the rock. Upon that revelation, I will build my church. And that is the church we are talking about today. The ideal church that is built on the revelation of who Jesus is. I don't know if you are catching it now. I will build my church upon this revelation of who Jesus is. Peter
Peter said, to whom shall we go? And we have believed and are sure. We are sure now. It means those who run away from church are those who are not sure that he is Christ, that he is the Son of the living God. They run in doubt. They run when things don't work. They run when they feel, God, you have disappointed me. But there are those who have come to know that he is the Christ and that he is the Son of the living God. He said, we will stick with you. Can I hear an amen from somebody? He said to Peter, upon this truth, upon this revelation, I will build my church. And what did he say? The gates of hell shall not prevail. So any church that the gate of hell prevails against is a church that is built on flesh and blood. And flesh and blood is looking for things. That is not the ideal church. Oh, that is a shocker. That's a shocker. The ideal church is not built on flesh and blood. The ideal church is built on the revelation of who Jesus is. Look at your neighbor. Say, Jesus is everything to me. Can I give you one scripture that will trip you? Romans 8. Let's check verse 32. Romans 8. Is somebody being blessed? I'm being blessed. I don't know about you. I'm happy. I'm blessed. The ideal church is not the church that seeks things. Can I shock you? The Bible says in Revelation that a new heaven and a new earth came, for the first heaven and earth melted away with a fervent heat. What that means is that everything you see on this earth is temporal. Everything will pass away. A new one will come. So why would you put your hope on things? Put your hope on the source. That's why somebody who wrote this hymn said, my hope is built on nothing less but Jesus Christ and righteousness. I dare not trust that but on Christ the solid. Hear you sing it again. Oh Lord, I grant. Yeah. Look at, they have brought it for you. Say, and I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first earth will pass away, and there were no more seas. This one will pass away. We are living for things. That is not the ideal church. The ideal church is a church that has come to know that Jesus is the Christ, is the Son of the living God. He is the Christ anointed for that need of yours. Romans and chapter 8, as we close tonight, verse 32. But I don't know if you are beginning to catch what the ideal church is. And I get the judge. I will talk to that honorable. That honorable. Yes. But you know, except the Lord builds a house, they labor in vain that built it. You can be talking to that honorable. That honorable has another person that will bribe him better than yourself. I like that church. If you go to that church, they will give you food to eat after service. That is why you come to church. The day we don't give you food, you will not come to church again. We come to church because we know he is the Christ. He is the Son of the living God. Why is it that people are easily deceived? Antichrist will come and start sharing rice. You see people rush there. Antichrist. Demonic agent will start sharing rice. You see people run there. You know why? People are always looking for things. They don't want to recognize a source. Oh, I don't know if you understand what I'm saying. Not yet. Let a juju man just paint a place and call it Church of Heaven. That kind of name. And cook 5 bags of rice. Human being will still go and eat there. Say free food. Oh, we have many. Let's not mention names. You are a farmer. Omega. That is who Jesus is. We worship you. So it's not because of what I get, but that is who he is. If he left everything to die for me, that's enough proof that everything I'm looking for has been settled. Let's read verse 32. One, two, go. He that spared not his own son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall he not with him also freely give us? That is what the unideal church is going for. But the ideal church go for the owner of all things. Come on, did you get what I just said? If God did not spare his son, you know what that means? God giving his son means he has given you your joy. He has given you your peace. He has given you your husband. He has given you your wife. He has given you your children. He has given you that job. He has given you that house. He has given you that car. Whatever you will ever need is in the all things. So the multitude followed him. I don't know how to best describe that word, multitude. Thousands. If not millions, multitude followed him. The Bible described because of what they saw. So if that thing is not there, they will stop following. Others came. Food. Food that you will eat. Highest, 24 hours. You have passed the unwanted one out of your body. Two of us. Some are following because of that. But Peter said, to whom shall we go? Doctor, come. To whom? Where? We have passed the level of food. We are not the one producing miracles. But there's one thing that makes us not to run away from you. You are the Messiah. You are the Christ. You are the Son of the living God. You have the word of eternal life. It means other things are not eternal. I don't know if you understand what I just said. Every other thing that makes the other side of the church not to follow Jesus, everything will end here. But Peter said, you have the word. That word that will catapult you to eternity. You have it. I will follow you because of that. Friends, it's good we know what the ideal church is. The ideal church is the church that sees Jesus as their source. That I've come to know he is the Son of the living God. That everything he does in your life is his right. He's never wrong in your life. Because there's nothing wrong in him. He that spared not his own son, but delivered him up for us all. Everybody say, how shall he not? You know, did you realize that is a question? Did you see how that statement ended? With a question. He's asking, how shall he not? With him, not outside of him. Freely give you. Everybody say, with him. My sister, say with him. So outside of him, you can't get it. You can come to church, and outside of him in church, you can't get all things. But if you are in church with him, you can get all things. I don't know if you are catching it. Say, Pastor, why are you talking like this? You know why? I owe everybody here a duty to teach you the word of God. Let it be that when I stand before the Father, I shared what you want me to share. I was not doing church because I was copying other people. God gives every man his pattern. He has given me my pattern, and I will teach you according to the pattern he has shown me. Do you want to get one other scripture? You want to get one scripture? Now, this is the essence why I teach you this thing. Ephesians 4. Maybe we'll read from verse number 12, 13, 14 to 18. I will just be fast. Because we are running out of time. We are running out of time. Let me just spend the next 5 minutes. Please, 11, so that they will understand. From 11. And he gave some what? What's the next one?
And what's the next one? And what's the next one? And what's the next one? Everybody say fivefold. So he gave fivefold. Now, for what purpose? Number one. For? So what is the meaning of perfecting? To mature the saints. Now, why do we need to mature? So that we don't see Jesus as things. We should see him as a source of all things. He wants us to mature. What's the next thing? Who will do the work of the ministry? You. We that are among the fivefold ministry, apostle, prophet, evangelist, pastors, and teachers, we will teach you so that you can do the work of the ministry. Is that okay? Now, the next word. What's the meaning of edify? To build up. So the purpose of the fivefold ministry gift is to equip you so that you'll be built up. Are you seeing it? Next. How many of us? In what? In the unity of faith. And of the knowledge. Is it the knowledge of things? Of Jesus Christ. Is it? Okay. Unto the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ. Next. We are not through. There's a column. That henceforth be no more tossed by what? And carried about with every wind. God does not want you. You run here. They tell you he's here. Run away. God is not in one place. Are you angry with me? There's a church that is shouting God is here. God is not in one place. You know what he said? He said, if they tell you, come to this mountain, he's here. He said, don't go. Go and read about the end time. Matthew 24. Read Luke. Read Mark. You see everything there. The signs of the end time. He said, they will call you. Say, he's in this mountain. He said, don't go. They will tell you he's in Jerusalem. Say, don't go. The purpose of the Holy Spirit is that he wants to fill everything in all. He wants to be everywhere at the same time. God is not in one particular location. You are not the carrier of God. For your body is a temple. That we henceforth. What's the meaning of henceforth? From now on. Thank you. You understand English? From now. God does not want them to shift you like this. Henceforth be tossed. Be children. Now, I want to ask you, what's the characteristics of children? I give you one. Anything goes. Number two, they want food, they cry. True? They are feeling pain, they cry. Mature people, once they are hungry, they know where the kitchen is. Nobody will lie to them again. But do you know that in the faith now, there are some people, what Christ has done for them, they are crying. No, you are still baby. You should know what is yours. Some people are looking for devil. Devil, leave me alone. And if you read the Bible, you and devil have no business. The devil is doing his work. You are doing your work. Quack your neighbor. Say, maintain your lane. And the devil has his own lane. People are just looking for the devil. People who are still looking for the devil, they are still babies. Then you first put water in the baby's mouth. You put milk. Sometimes the mother will say, it's like this baby is feverish. It's medicine, this one is now. They can't talk. Babies anywhere you carry them to. And that is what is happening in the body of Christ. The Bible says, henceforth. Don't let people deceive you. Come. There is a woman, she can see, eh? Let the woman help herself first. What did I say? Let the woman help herself. She can see, and Nigeria is still like this. Eh? Are you here? I said she can see, and Nigeria is still like this. Go and check our family members. They are still like that. Our community is still like that. And she can. Let me take you to one place. Are you not tired? Every time, your pastor. Let me take you somewhere. Anybody that must take you, let them take you to the Son of God. Show you the word of eternal life. This is how mature children behave. Praise God. Let me read this. That we henceforth be no more children, tossed to and fro, and carried about with every wind by the sleight of men and cunning craftiness whereby they lie in wait to do what? So the devil has anointed some people to deceive others. Give me English, modern English Bible, so that we close for tonight. How many of you have been blessed? Me, I'm blessed. And I know you are blessed. Awesome God, how great thou art. You alone. Give me message or energy. I am a miracle. Stand of your holy name. I've gotten the word I'm looking for. Lord, we it's like those who dab, they are bowing to God too. Praise God. Alright, can we read message together? Do you like it? Should we read? 1, 2, go. God wants us to grow up, to know the whole truth and tell it in love, like Christ in everything. We take our lead from where? Who is all? I think that summarizes what we have been teaching. Who is your source? Peter said, thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. You have the word of eternal life. That is the ID church. The ID church will take the lead from Christ and focus on their source, that is Christ. Praise the name of the Lord. How many of you have been blessed tonight? Just bow down your head. Say, thank you. I'm a member. I'm a part of that ID church. I'm a member. I'm a part of that ID church. I want you to know, whatever you trust God for, I'm going to pray. That miracle can come. The bread will come. Every good thing you trust Him will come. But I want you to know, He's the source. He's not just a miracle. He's the source of the miracle. It's not just healing. Let's rise on our feet. I want to pray. Whatever you're trusting God for, let's rise up. Just break it. I want us to pray. Jesus wants to be made manifest in this place. Everybody, close your eyes. Mention that thing to Him. Whatever that thing is, He's the source. I will pray. Just mention that thing to Him. Everybody, you need one thing or the other. Mention that thing. If it's a miracle you need, if it's a healing tonight, He does miracles, but He does not want you to pursue miracles. If it is political connection you need, He does it, but He wants your mind to be focused on Him. Oh, thank you. We bless your name. Lambon DC Farahasa Elakasto Shibalahai Braga Subrehizabaha. Thank you, Father. I bring everyone under the sound of my voice before you. Lord, as many that need creative miracle, those that need healing, those that need supernatural provision, there are those that say, Lord, even food I don't have to eat. The God of provision. Paul said, my God, supply all your needs according to His riches in glory by Christ Jesus. I stand by the anointing of God over my life. I prophesy supernatural provision. In the name of Jesus, I speak to every part of your body. Wherever you need creative miracle, wherever you need healing, I speak healing right now in the name of Jesus. That part of your body, they say only a miracle can make it work. I command creative miracle. The God that creates your body part, He has spares. From the heavens of God, I release spares of your bodily parts in the name of Jesus. There are those that need connection, governmental, leadership connection. I stand today and I decree, the source of all these things is Jesus. I demand the release of those things in the name of Jesus. For those trusting God for wife, husband, children, father, the Bible says, oh God, every good and perfect gift comes from you. I release the good, I release the perfect into their life in the name of Jesus. On account of this word tonight, let testimony come out of your life. Father, confirm this word. In Jesus' name we pray.